Warning. The show you're about to see contains material unsuitable for children and questionable among most adults. Viewer discretion is advised.
Extra! Retailers receive notice of further impressive price. Oh, hey, I didn't see you standing there. Name's Danny. Danny Hudson. You know, like the Hudson Valley Credit Union. Nice to meet you. Suppose I'm hosting the special this week, but I ain't that much of a host. Sorry to tell you. I'm a newsie. I sell papes. I hope you don't mind being a fly on the wall. I got a job to do. Extra, extra, cabinet woes in Germany. Lower house of Prussian diet rejects canal bill. 300 books added to British Museum. Ah, nuts. Nobody's ever gonna buy papes like this with boring headlines like these.
Hey, what are you doing up so late anyway, huh? You should get some rest.
Ah. I thought I'd get a head start, try selling yesterday's newspaper.
But that's old news!
Have you read this thing? It's all old news! Same old, same old, and we're stuck with worthless papes at the end of the day. Now, how's it going, newsies?
Hey.
That's right. Hey, wait a minute. You, up front. Not you, out of here. I'm talking to you, Curly.
Who, me? Whoa!
I ain't never seen you selling papes before.
Well, that's a account of the fact that I'm new on the block.
These look like some nice pants you got.
Oh, these were my great-great-great-grandfather's. My dad just gave them to me on account of the fact that he can't wear pants no more.
What? Your dad?
Yeah, my father. He can't wear pants anymore because of his illness.
Don't you know that we're all orphans?
Well, yeah, I guess.
What's your name, kid?
Me? My name's Danny Baxter.
Danny Baxter, Danny Hudson. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
You know what I'm gonna call you? Spoony Baxter. On account of a silver spoon being born in your mouth.
Oh man! What a load of baloney! You know, my dad, the person that I'm doing this job for, has that illness where he's a 45-year-old man, but he looks like he's 10.
I ain't never hear that illness before.
Yeah, and it's worse, too. He has spinal Alzheimer's.
What the heck is spinal Alzheimer's?
It's like Alzheimer's in your brain, but it's in your spine. And it makes it so he forgets things, but in his body.
Well, you know what? Spoony sticks. We all got nicknames. Why don't you tell them what yours is?
Hey, yeah, I've always liked the opportunity to say my nickname. Yeah. Well, the nickname for me is Spitshine, on account of how I'll spitshine your shoes. And right after, I scuff them up real good. To leave a little bit of honest work for the next spitshine guy.
Yeah, my name's Dime Eldridge, because I'm going to give you a real shine on your face, unless you give me a dime.
And I'm Bumfoot Baruch, on account of my bum foot, I suppose.
He's slow, in the foot. If you want to roll with us, then you got to toughen up. And I don't think you got it, rich boy.
Well, look, I'm going to sell these papes to the best of my ability. I promise you that.
We don't care.
Yeah.
We know that if you fail at this job, then you're just gonna run home to mommy and daddy and say, "Give me a dollar."
Yeah.
You know, it gets worse for me. You know what else? My
what?
Dad?
What?
Well, everything my dad has is genetic, which means I'm gonna get it any day now. And so every newspaper in my hand, every single day I devote here, who knows how much longer I got? Sure, I got a dad and you orphans are all upset, but to be honest, I think you guys are just a bunch of orphan freaks.
You said the one thing that really gets me boiled up. I don't like being called an orphan, even though I am one. Not by one of you parent kids. Spoony. Silver spoon. Because you can go back to your family. If you have a rough day, you got a bed to sleep in. You got somebody looking out for you. Ain't nobody looking out for me. Because when they see me walking down the street, all they see is street trash. I wish I was far away. Some place that I've long dreamt of. A place that isn't cold and hard and gray. I wish I could plan tomorrow. No more fight for today. In Flagstaff, Arizona's where I'd stay. Balmy air, desert sun. No more of the hustle bustle. No more bulls and coppers calling me riffraff. If I miss the big skyscrapers, I'll just buy a photograph. Dreams come true. Yeah, they do. In Flagstaff. Why can't I be in Kokomino County? Just a stone's throw away from Humphrey's Peak. If I only had the finance, and I'd head to the future home attendance and take a trip to Oak Creek Canyon off of Route 66 or the Navajo Festival of Arts and Crafts. No more Giants, no more Dodgers, make Cardinals my team. Far from the lousy headlines and the deadlines in between. Oh, Flagstaff, my old friend. I can't spend my whole life dreaming, though I know that's all I seem to do. I ain't getting any younger. And I wanna start brand new. 'Cause New York don't compare. You might say I got a boner. I don't care. Flagstaff, Arizona. I'll be there. Away from the commuting, the polluting, and the looting. And my highfalutin' dreams might make you laugh. I got nothing if I ain't got old Flagstaff!
Oh. Sorry, pussy.
Oh.
Let's go sell some papers!
Mr. Bannon, what you got for us today?
What the fuck are you doing with your papes?
Hey, why don't you give us some papes without those boring headlines you're always slacking?
Boring, yeah. You want to talk about boring headlines, right? What do you want to talk about? What do you fucking know about writing papes, huh? You're not but a newsie. You can't even read, you orphans. You're probably all Catholics, aren't you? Huh? I can smell it. What are you, a Spaniard?
Huh? Mr. Bannon, just give us the papes so we can make the money, please, Mr. Bannon.
It all work. You give me the money, I give you the papes, and you go do whatever the hell you want with it. You leave me alone with my sandwiches and my cupcakes. All right?
You know, I sure am hungry. You don't mind if I...
We ain't gonna do. It pays our selling the way I'm supposed to, you know that.
That's because of these boring headlines.
Why you spice them up? Huh? Spice them up! I said spice them up! Split them up!
What do you mean? Give us an example.
Well, okay, so you see the one? Oh, it goes really good together. Let's say you got a hotel owner injured during sign cleaning, right? That's what it says here. Why you can spruce it up, make it Catholic bastard stone feeble innkeeper during morning flag raising. People love that. Okay. You know? Aww. Or you can take this one, you know, I'm sure there's many. You got like, you're perfect. Automobile crushed by watering cart could be illiterate Catholic rosary spell murders elderly woman in automobile catastrophe. Huh? Yeah. Perth Amboy bank auction turns into Catholic treachery causes global financial ruin.
Oh, yeah.
Never thought of that, did you? Huh?
You know, you got something there, Mr. Bannon.
Hey, look. I don't want to be a stick in the mud. Oh. But
all right,
what
here
about,
goes Spoonie.
Well, hey, listen up, all right? Listen up. What about journalistic integrity? Huh? What about the service that we give to the community? Huh?
You yell headlines, you sell papes. What do you know about integrity, you fucking orphan? Huh? What do you know? You know, you probably think you're fucking special like you're a little snowflake, huh?
Well...
Right, what do you think, huh? You fucking liberal. That's right, you're one of them.
Technically, I'm not an orphan. I've got a dad.
Don't Catholic dad? Us. Where's your dad from? Is he from Prussia? Huh?
No.
Huh? What, are you speaking German?
No.
Huh? You can't read or write German?
No, I speak English. Look, all I'm saying is, why not sell the paper as is? Look at it, it's beautiful.
I don't know about you, Daddy's boy, but I got money to make.
Let's take these boring papes and try to spice them up. Hmm. Let's go, extra, extra! Extra, extra!
No, I'm talking to you.
Sorry about this. I know I'm not talking to you much. I got a job to do. And speaking of jobs, I know somebody that actually writes for the papes. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Sopan Deb!
Yeah! Woo! Woo!
Woo! How's it going?
Oh, very
Take
good.
A
Thank
seat.
You.
Come on, fellas. Let's interview. So, what's it like writing for the New York Times?
Oh man, it's a lot of fun. It's a lot of fun writing for the New York Times. We get a lot of hate, but it's still a lot of fun. It's a great gig.
You're a culture editor.
Writer, but yeah, I write about culture.
Sorry.
Editors are my boss.
So. I don't really know. I read the word editor and then don't know what it means.
I'm a writer, so...
I'm not too bright that way.
Yeah, so culture is comedy, theater, art,
thank you.
Do I turn this on? Oh, no, I think it's on. All right, anyway, so comedy is theater, comedy, culture,
Did
art.
We hear any of that? Should I just start over? I think we're good.
Okay, anyway, so yeah, that's a lot of what I read about.
So what's it like? Are you going to big fancy galas? Rubbing elbows with the hoi polloi?
No, not that many fancy galas. I do see a lot of shows.
What kinds of shows?
A lot of Broadway, you know, a lot of, you know, movie screenings, a lot of, you know, classical music, comedy, a lot of comedy shows. So, yeah, a lot of that kind of stuff.
And I heard the word on the street is you're a funny guy yourself.
Some people say that. I don't know if I would describe myself like that, but yeah, I would say that I partake in comedy every now and then.
You do some stand-up comedy.
I do. I started doing stand-up about 6 years ago, yeah.
Wow. Maybe someday I could be on a stage. Maybe in Flagstaff. So anyways, I heard you followed somebody named Mr. Donald Trump around the country recently.
I did. Before I worked at the Times, I was at CBS, and I was part of a group of about 5 to 10 people that followed him around the country for about a year and a half. Gave up my apartment and the whole thing, went to more than 40 states and hundreds of rallies with him.
Wow. And what was that like?
It was not boring. It was a crazy experience, but it was an incredible experience at the same time because I got to meet people and see places around the country I wouldn't otherwise get to see. And Trump rallies themselves were interesting because, you know, people would line up the night before. They were like little concert festivals. People would show up dressed like him. He'd do them in these big basketball arenas, and like thousands of people would show up. It was unlike any other political rally you will ever see.
Now, I gotta be honest. We're all from 1899, see?
Yeah.
And right. We don't really know who this Donald Trump guy is. Give us a primer.
Oh boy, he's the president now. How do I describe Donald Trump?
Let's back up a second. How'd a guy like that become president?
Oh, wow.
I'm gonna add on to that. A guy like what?
Boy, it's gonna be a fun 80 years or so for you guys coming up here.
If I guessed about the president, I'd say he lives in a big skyscraper, and all his walls and floors are gold. He's got a beautiful wife that's a supermodel.
Wow, you're very perceptive. Wow. That's, wow. So Donald Trump is a businessman, and he hosts, he used to host a reality television show, and I realize you guys don't know what television is. Mm-mm. You guys don't have...
Nope.
You guys... well, it's this box. It's an electric... Do you guys have electricity at this point?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Is that ignorant?
Yeah.
Is that
some reporter you are? You got the big scoop tonight.
all right. Well, it's this box where you could watch like moving pictures in an electric box of sorts, and eventually he hosts.
Oh, like a kinetoscope.
Yeah. You should have just said kinetoscope.
I'm sorry. You're right. I should have said kinetoscope. I'm sorry. You're right. That's my mistake. And he eventually goes from this electric box to being the most powerful person in the whole world.
Well, that makes sense to me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Clear as day.
Yeah, that's pretty much how that went.
So how'd it feel following this big shot around?
You know, I get asked that question a lot, and you know what the truth is, I'm not copping out. You don't have time to think about it because you're sometimes in like 4 or 5 different states in a day. You're writing 5 to 10 stories, not 10 stories, but you're writing a lot of stories in a day, and there's so much news going on that you don't have time to think. You're just like going from one thing to the next, and there's so much. He could make 5 to 10 headlines in the course of an hour, and you're exhausted just keeping up with it. So I didn't think about it much. I think about it a lot more now that I'm done with that part of my life. So I know that's not a fun answer. But, you know.
Well, I want to talk about something fun. I heard you won some awards for your journalistic enterprises.
Not recently. No, I have won some. But the thing is, like, awards in journalism, like, there are a lot of them, and they don't really matter. You know, like, they don't, most journalists you talk to can say they've won an award of some sort, and now they can call themselves an award-winning journalist, you know? Some of the best journalists I know have never won, like, an award, per se. You know, there are only a few handful of journalism awards that really matter, but even the best reporters don't really care about them. You know what I mean? Hmm.
So you influence what people are talking about. What's something in the culture of your day, the modern day, that you like? What are you excited about?
Oh, what am I excited about? Well, Trump in culture is really interesting because there's never been a president in the history of our country that has had the pop culture crossover that Trump does. Trump has a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. You'll know what that is like 50, 60 years down the road. He was literally the executive producer of a television show while he's president. He has appeared in a number of movies and television shows. He hosted he hosted WrestleMania once. I could begin to explain WrestleMania, but that's a whole nother thing. So there's never, and this is a guy who's willing to weigh in on every pop culture thing of the day. Like, he'll talk about Meryl Streep, who's going to be the most famous actress, in about, 90 years from now. And he'll talk about Hamilton, which is eventually will become the most famous Broadway play in history.
Oh, is it about Alexander Hamilton?
Yeah, that's the guy, right, yeah.
Alexander Hamilton, I'll skip it.
So it's it's really interesting watching how our culture responds to a guy like that. Because he's changed the culture, too. So if you look at a lot of our award shows, it becomes about Donald Trump often. A lot of the speeches are about him. A lot of, like, Eminem, who is a rapper. Rap music is another thing that will emerge 80 years from now. You know, he's dropping random freelance rhymes about Donald Trump. And that's an interesting thing to watch, how one person is kind of shifting an entire cultural movement.
Oh, man. If I was ever a big TV producer, I'd make an award show myself. I'd take all the beautiful teenage girls in all the states in the country, and I'd put them in bikinis and make them parade around.
You are very perceptive. Wow. Yeah. One might say you're ahead of your time.
Oh, great.
Yeah.
I bet Donald Trump ain't ever got an idea like that. Yeah.
Yes, well, no, I think he did have a couple ideas like that.
Oh. Well, that's
but
cool.
But, like, after you, though. You know what I mean?
Well, after me, yeah.
Yeah, like, your idea's now.
Mm.
So you invented it.
Maybe.
I'll
change my name, and I'll attend some white power rallies, and then I'll give birth to the next Donald Trump.
I have no comment.
No comment. Fair enough. So what else are you excited about, aside from the Trump garbage?
Let's see. There's a lot of. I wouldn't say I'm excited about this. This is not something I'm excited about, but I would say there's a cultural conversation happening about. this is kind of dark for a late night comedy show, but you know, there's an interesting.
I bet my reaction won't be appropriate.
there's a big conversation happening right now. This is the other big conversation happening in our culture right now. It's about sexual misconduct in the workplace. Right. So that's happening. Especially now, there are a number of A-list celebrities and movie producers and politicians that are now dealing with this reckoning of empowerment for women. And it's interesting to see how that manifests itself today, because it really has not happened at this level previously.
How do you think that's going to influence culture moving forward?
We don't know. That's the interesting thing about it, is that this is unprecedented in many ways. You're seeing a lot of A-list comics, for example, and A-list, like Louis C.K.'s of the world, and A-list actors like Kevin Spacey, and a lot of people are having to reckon with this. And
if only there was a way, us being in the past and all, that we could say Kevin Spacey's bad, and then nobody is going to have this trouble.
Right. Mm. But in theory, what's going to happen now is that there's going to be more awareness, and women will not have to deal with what they have had to deal with. What a large number of women have had to deal with over the last several decades. And I realize that in a small thread is something to be excited about, even though these stories themselves are pretty horrifying. But the benefit is that in theory it'll improve things in workplaces 80, 90 years from now.
Yeah.
Well, more than that. Sorry, more than a century from now. Right.
We don't let girls be newsies, because they're weak with the arms.
Yeah.
Right. Right. Well, this is what we're talking about.
I don't think my attitude's gonna change for another 100 years.
Yeah!
Yeah! what else do you like to do?
What else do I like to do?
Yeah.
Say, I got a question.
I had notes and they disappeared. Probably because I was throwing papers around.
I got a question.
Yeah, yeah.
How do you guys deal with polio?
How do we deal with polio? There's a guy named, is that Jonas Salk that I think comes along at some point, maybe like 50 years from now?
Oh yeah, I know him.
Wait, little Joey Salk?
Yeah!
From Staten Island?
Joey
what,
Salk.
He gets polio?
No, he accidentally discovers penicillin. And that cures polio.
Wow, yeah. Wow.
Yeah, that's how we deal with polio in 2018. Yes.
What else can you give us from the future? Warnings.
What should I warn 1899? Where are we? Are we in America? Like, where are we right now?
We're in New York City.
We're in New York City.
I wish that I was in Flagstaff, Arizona.
Eventually, we're going to walk on the moon, believe it or not.
Nah. Oh, you're kidding me.
Yeah.
Fake news.
We're gonna go back a bunch of times through the 60s and the early 70s, and then we're never going to go back again. Like, and then we're just going to go to the moon and then forget about it.
That's the one thing you wanted to warn us about?
I love space. I love the
we'll
moon.
We'll go to the moon a couple times.
Yeah.
The 20th century. Good to know. Okay.
Yeah. There's going to be a really great movie called The Godfather, an amazing sequel that comes with that.
Uh-huh.
And then they're going to try to make a third one.
Uh-huh.
Don't let him make the third one.
Don't let him make the third one. Okay.
Yeah.
So that'll be first on my list.
Yeah.
Right after.
Please.
Right after my parents moved back to Poland.
Oh, boy.
Well, you know, I for one, am just really pleased to hear that there's no war.
Good, yeah.
Yeah.
I'm glad it ended with Spanish American.
Mm-hmm. I'm told, I've been told by my friends not to do spoiler alerts, so I don't want to spoil anything.
I don't know what that is.
I don't want to tell you how anything ends, so.
A spoiler alert for us is we eat a piece of bad chicken and then we vomit for 4 days.
Oh. Yeah.
No one comes to help us.
Mm-mm. A refrigerator is going to be invented at some point soon for that, so.
Ooh.
Refrigerator?
It's a cold, there's gonna be a movie that comes out called Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure.
Uh-huh.
And I feel like I'm Bill and Ted right now. It's a movie about where they go back in time and basically bring a bunch of old people into from the past into the future. And anyway,
How do they do that?
Through a phone booth, believe it or not.
Phone booth?
Yeah.
What's
do we
that?
Have phone booths yet? Oh man, if I can go back to 1950, I would be much more. I could definitely show you guys, tell you guys what's what. Like 1900 or so is like a little before like my like explanation level.
All right. Well, this is the as advanced as we've come as a people.
Right. That's true. Right. Wait. It's 1899. I'm surprised you guys aren't looking at me like why like
why?
Why?
I'm like,
why?
Seem like a nice guy to me.
Yeah. What are you talking about? I think you're great.
Oh, okay.
Nice Jewish kid.
You guys are very, very advanced for 1899, I guess is my point.
All right.
You know, I'm just, you know, pointing that out.
We're just kids from New York City.
Yeah. The melting pot of the United States.
Right, okay. Oh, fair. That's
all
fair.
All right. Well, thanks so much for coming on the show. You're welcome to stick around, but we're going to be talking to Mr. Bannon quite a bit.
Oh, great.
So,
well, thank you for having me.
It's an option.
Thank you. I think I'm going to go back to my time now.
Everybody, Sopan Deb! Thanks so much for being here.
Thanks for having me.
Hey, everybody, let's prance on back to Mr. Bannon. Hi, Mr. Bannon. Boy, could I have one of these donuts?
I will break every one of your fucking orphan fingers, kid. What are you looking? What's up with the French one?
I'm just a little kid.
Look, am I still a little kid? I'll pull you over my knee and then I'll choke you to death.
Mr. Bannon.
No, go away from my sandwiches.
Mr. Bannon, we've been trying to sell these papes, but it's hard to
come
up.
You trying to do the new headlines?
Well, we tried to spice them up, but some of them are so boring. About labor strikes and about the walls coming down. I don't know how to spice these things up.
You fucking millennials are all the same. You don't know how to do Yeah, the millennium. 1900. That's 20 centuries. That's two millennia. You fucking dinghead.
Whoa,
watch
it.
Come on,
Mr. B. Yeah. Come on.
Yeah.
If you didn't control the papes, I might suck.
Yeah, what are you gonna do?
I might suck you.
Listen. You millennials think that you just gotta have everything given to you. That the headlines are just gonna write themselves is not the way it works. You having trouble spicing them up? Make them up.
Make up the headlines.
Just lie. Come up with new ideas. Make them up.
Huh.
Just.
I got an idea.
We got one.
What if I'm on the streetcar and I say, extra, air affair, McKinley cop playing hokey pokey with Vice Pres Hobart's daughter. Right? I want to read that story.
Yeah, it sounds good.
Sounds perfect.
I like
the battle happy.
Not bad.
Come on, guys, get a hold of yourself. Somebody's got to be the voice of reason about here. Huh?
Extra, read all about it. Bumfoot runs in again.
Hey, guys, wait up.
Bumfoot, come on.
Sorry, I'm late. What's happening?
Bumfoot, we already talking about we're gonna make up headlines now.
Oh, make up headlines.
Yeah, you like that?
Yeah. Like, I don't know. Maybe, a crazy Spaniard eats a demon Mongolian.
That's a good idea.
That actually might be in here somewhere.
All right, boys, should we get to selling?
That's good.
Well, if anybody objects, let me know right now.
I'm just saying, you guys, maybe we should be a little more careful. I think the truth is good enough.
We tell them the headlines, we sell them the paper, and then we run off. And then they won't have to complain that the article's not in the paper.
All right. Well, I guess I'll do it just this once.
All right, let's get to selling. This is going great. We're making more money than ever. I'm gonna pause for a minute for the viewing audience and tell you about something that's happening way in the future. You could see this band playing February 10th at Kingsland in Greenpoint, Brooklyn.
Brooklyn?
And look out for a new EP in the next couple of weeks. Give it up for Diary.
Coming back tomorrow, my never so old. Never so torn. Inside, a host of apathy, a quiet insanity. Impossible to say. I'm so good, I'm a dog. She came in and sat down on the floor. I saw her go. She said, "That's the record. It's all you get from this place. The best sunshine is all you'll ever know. It's all you get from this place. The face of shame is all you'll ever know. Oh. At night, the sky is filled with thoughts I could just look at and shine with the eyes of mine. It's here, the school set good things on the just a silent team, but the world is free. I saw a girl by the day. I saw a hooter in there. I saw a girl. She said, "That's super good. It's all you get from this. The face of shame is all you'll ever know. The face of regret is all you'll ever know. This way. The face of shame is all you'll ever know."
What's up, guys? Zach Trevor here. It's 4 a.m. It's a new day. We're going to tear it up and get fit. Now, a lot of you have been asking in the comments, so here you finally have it. A video where I show you what I put in my body and what my fitness regimen is. All right, let's get it, baby. All right, now, first things first, a smoothie. That's my roommate. All right, now, I like to think of breakfast as Superfood City. So we're going to go to the fridge, which is a little bit like Superfood Home Depot. Now, I buy most of these ingredients fresh, because once this stuff starts going bad, you're going to lose all those good micronutrients. All right, let's grab these ingredients.
I forgot something. Let's grab those ingredients.
Is this your chia, dude? Now, with smoothies, I got two words for you. Nutrient stack and customization. So you're going to want to build your smoothie based on your needs. This week, it's protein week, so this smoothie is going to be packed with chia. You're going to want to layer it on your blender. So very, very simple. It's just going to be chia, kale, peanut butter, repeat. Chia, kale, peanut butter, repeat. Chia, kale, peanut butter, repeat. Chia, kale, peanut butter. All right, now let's whip it up. I picked this recipe up when I was a raw fruitarian. Now, I was a raw fruitarian for 9 months, but I had to stop because I was defecating 30% of my bone marrow. All right, we got our smoothie. We're charged up. Let's hit the streets. All right, start off with a light jog, 30 minutes right before my workout. Gonna go to the park and tear my ACL. I'm really stoked. All right, we're here at the park and it's a beautiful day.
just gonna do some stretching because I don't wanna pull a muscle when I start my workout, all right? So I'm gonna just stretch out my thighs. I'm gonna stretch them out real nice. Now, here's a pro tip. You're not doing it right unless you're blasting your thighs wide open. So I'm trying to tenderize right now, get muscles nice and tender, kind of like a chicken breast. So today I'm trying to tear my ACL, which honestly isn't even funny because I did tear my ACL once and it got the avian flu. So hey, we're all warmed up, all stretched out. We're all about ready to go home and go to sleep. But first, a quick pit stop. Let's go. So I'm standing here at this undeveloped plot of land. I'm gonna break ground on my new fitness center here. Now, there were a whole lot of problems with red tape and permits because I had to knock down a charter school to get this, but this is gonna be the place to tear it up and get fit. So yeah, there's actually a dumbbell already that I put in there. I'm gonna have to check with the town though because I'm not sure if it's zoned for that. Yeah, they just put this barbed wire up because I was getting so eager and like I wanted to start work on it, and they were like, no, listen, once the permits come through, you can start, but you know, we're gonna put the barbed wire in there for now. Sauna room, juice bar, climbing wall. I don't know why there's a tree here, but you know, honestly, I kind of like it. I think they could keep it. All right, cool, let's head home.
I'm exhausted, but you know, had a good day today, tore it up, got fit. Actually, it's fucked. I tore four of my ACLs, so I'm gonna have to take it easy for a while, but you know, tomorrow back at it again, 4 a.m. when Sprint's at the riverfront. All right, remember to share, like, subscribe, and thanks so much to all my fans for letting me do what I do day in, day out. All right, have a good night.
Summon Chinese dragon to destroy San Francisco monastery.
Some sensational headlines for you. Somebody insulted the owner or the creator of the new X-ray. They said, hey, buddy, quit being so negative, folks. Thank you. Thank you. Good crowd. They also, somebody insulted the guy who created this new medication that helps people with diabetes. They said, hey, buddy, why don't you... there weren't shots fired. It was insulin shots fired, folks. Thank you. Thank you. What did you write today? What did you write today, pal? Somebody insulted the person who just made this new invention called aerosol. They said, hey, buddy, you're polluting the environment almost as bad as Aerosmith, folks. I hope you enjoy. Thank you very much. I love this crowd. All right, there you go.
Roosevelt Foundation funneling dead corpses to Spanish King.
George Bernard Shaw's a talentless cook.
Teddy Roosevelt eats a baby with his big fucking teeth.
McKinley's undercover. Barnum and Bailey, bestial sex ring. The Spanish-American War in general. Mr. Bannon? I have a message from you from the far right side of New York City. Dear Mr. Bannon, I regret to inform you, you are no longer an employee of Breitbart News. Please leave immediately.
What?
Oh, brother, that sucks. This is a terrible time not to have a job right now. My dad lost his job, and he hasn't been the same since.
Yes.
Newsies! Newsies!
Man, we're making so much cooler!
Newsies!
I only have a big head!
Newsies! Newsies! Gather around!
It's still
gather around! Gather around! Gather here! Here, everybody, split a donut! Split a donut! Between all of you! Here, a little bit for you!
Come on!
Not me first!
Come on, a little bit. There you go.
It's the smallest bit.
You gotta wait!
One! What?
Just what I...
Here, that's just a couple pieces of bread. Now listen, kids. I got some good news. I got some bad news. The good news is you're with Mr. Bannon.
Yeah.
The bad news is no more papes. They fired us. They abandoned us.
No more papes?
What the?
How are we going to make a living?
The time has come. We're going to sink the Bismarck. We're going to napalm every one of these motherfuckers. We're going to drop truth bombs. We're going to drop...
You okay, Mr. Bannon?
Yes!
So good.
I'm fine! It's just the pox. Listen. We're done. We're gonna make our own newspaper. We're gonna make our own news. We're gonna take this city down. We're gonna get the deep state. We're gonna find the dark web. We're gonna get
the printing press.
Why are we gonna make a printing press?
Yeah.
I have a printing press. I'm the modern day Benjamin Franklin.
Oh, yeah.
That's right. We're going to do it. We have the capabilities. We got the headlines, right? You guys came up with all the headlines. Huh? Huh? Now we can invent the news however we see fit.
Okay, well, Mr. B, I hate to be a stick in the mud, but wouldn't that...
Oh, spoon.
Baby.
Now, who else has an opinion they want to share with Mr. Bannon?
Why'd you kill him? I know he's a rich kid, but he was a good sort.
He's a cuck, a snowflake, a liberal, a leftist. He's part of the media elite. He's a globalist. And we're going to get him. We're going to get them all. We're gonna get the Prussians. We're gonna get the Indo-Chinese. We're gonna get them all. Hey, look. What's wrong, Danny? Huh? You think he was your friend? Spooner? Whatever the fuck his name was? He was a Catholic. He was a Catholic. And you know what the Catholics are planning on doing? Huh?
No.
They're gonna drop a bomb on the United States.
Aw, dang.
And you know where?
Where?
In the United States.
Where?
Lucky for you, not New York City. They're dropping it in Flagstaff, Arizona. And he was behind it. So, you with me? Or are you against me?
You saying that we don't just spruce up the headlines. We don't just make up the headlines. We make up the whole news, a newspaper, full of stuff that we made up.
Yeah, we create reality.
Then I could be whatever I want. I could be a big movie star. I could live in a big cold room in a big skyscraper.
Yeah.
You know what? I like Spoonie, but good riddance. Let's get printing.
We're gonna take down the Prussians! We're going to the deep state! We're getting rid of the tax system! We're getting rid of women! We're getting rid of Europeans! It's gonna be America first! That's right! Go on! Who's with me? Go on, you need! Go on!
Bannon!
Bannon! Bannon! Bannon!
Maybe we don't chant that.
All
right. Maybe we don't chant that.
You know what? This is the dawning of a new day.
That's right.
We're no longer newsies that nobody cares about. We're no longer riffraff. We're the kings of New York. Hit it!
A pair of new shoes with matching laces.
A permanent box at the sheeps and races.
A porcelain bath with boiling water.
A night with mayor's friggin' daughter.
Look at me, I'm the king of New York. Staring right at you, easy with the stature. Now I'm up and
hey
over,
guys,
hot,
up.
Hot. Oh,
wait
come
up,
on.
Guys, sorry, I'm late.
Oh, my foot.
Oh, my God, it's terrible. It's terrible. You won't believe it. Have you read that new paper, the
Don't worry about
Times?
That. Yeah, we just talked to them.
Horrible.
It's going to be great.
They bombed Flagstaff. It's all over. It's all
Prussians.
Over.
No, no,
it
no.
It was the Prussians that bombed them, yeah!
Yeah.
But Bumfoot doesn't need to hear.
That's why I'm bombing us. I don't want to live in this world anymore.
Think about this. This maybe what you read ain't the truth.
Hey, just because I got a bum fit don't mean I got a bum brain.
Oh, I'm boy.
All up in three.
No.
Two.
No. 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 Tonight's episode was based on a story by Philip K. Dick. And now, once again, give it up for Diary! Woo!
Oh.
not!